Okay, so welcome to Learn to Code part one. We're going to start with using Python here. And Python is a good one to use because it's fairly common and there's loads and loads of resources online, and it's kind of transferable to other programming languages as well. So I'm on a Mac here, but if you want to, you can use it on a PC. You can download it for free from python.org. And if you just type in IDLE to start with, IDLE, and that should open up the shell just here. And the shell is where the output of your programs go. So to actually code, we want to start up in the File menu and go to New File. And this will bring up the area where we can code just here. So the output of the program is here, and where we code is here. And it's often a sensible idea to arrange the two windows side by side. So we'll just start with the program everybody starts with. Oops, I can spell it right. Can't spell. Finally got there. There we go. So what we've got here is print, and you can see that's gone kind of purpley, which means it's a command word. And we've opened a bracket, and we've put hello world, and we've encased it in speech marks and closed the brackets. Okay, anything in speech marks here is known as a string. So this is kind of the first term you might come across. This is a string. And what should happen is when we run this program, it should print out into the shell just on the left-hand side here. So it should print out the words hello world. So let's try it. If we press F5 on the keyboard to run it, it'll ask us to save. And I'm just going to put it on my desktop. And once it's saved, hopefully, we should see it appear on the left-hand side. There we go. Hello, world. So this is our first line of code we've written. And you can make the computer do your bidding. So you could type in anything you like. And it should print it. Okay. Just pay attention here to your syntax. Okay. And what we mean by that is the actual code, the order you type code in, because if you miss things, say for example I miss out the last speech mark there, what will happen is you'll get a error. Okay, EOL stands for end of line, so it means there's something wrong with the end of this code here, and we know it's a speech mark, so I can correct that, run it, and do that. There we go. So a couple of little exercises. Try printing out some things using the print command. See if you can print some empty blank lines using the print command. How can you do that? Have a little think and have a play around with print.